of thy people. In short, Michael is a special name that defeats the masked mask. Michael is a special name. When you are falling your battle, you are failing against sin, you are failing against the world, you are failing against everything, Michael will stand for you. Victory will not defeat you. Victory will not pull you down. No, sin will never destroy you, because there is a Michael for us. Will somebody say an amen there? We are talking about unmasking the masked enemy. I fear this angel. Revelation 12, verse 1. So there was war. He was defeated. The one who defeated him, Michael. And we understand it's what? Jesus. Look at verse 12. Chapter 12. There appeared a great wonder in heaven. A woman was clothed with the sun. Not just that. And the moon under her feet, representing both the Old and the New Testament. A woman represents the church. We're going to go deep into that in next week. And have a crown of 12 stars. The 12 disciples of Jesus, the 12 patriarchs in the book or in the Old Testament. She begins with child cry, traveling in birth, and pained to deliver. And the dragon. Imagine it. A woman was about to give birth, and she was in pain. The waters in her uterus burst forth. She wanted to pull. She was traveling. And the Bible says, and the dragon stood before the woman, which was ready to be delivered, for to devour her child as soon as it was born. A personality is described here. Satan is anti-people's life and is anti-people's salvation. I hate him. He doesn't like me, so I don't like him either. Satan is depicted in the book of Revelation. He's not a friend. He's not a colleague. He's not a person to play with. A woman about to give birth. Woman representing the church. A child representing Christ. And this is so vivid. You want to doubt it? Satan foresaw that the child that will be born will bring salvation to humanity. Matthew chapter 1, verse 21. And you shall give birth to a son, and you shall call his name Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins. He was aware. This is who he is. He foresees the potentials in people, and he either aborts the pregnancy, or he'll be ready to devour the child in its infant state. So Jesus, whilst he was in the womb, Satan had made an agenda that he must be killed. Luke 2, verse 7. And she brought forth her first son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes. And the Bible said, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. And you know, there and there, Herod, because Jesus, Michael defeated him in heaven. Michael defeated him on various issues. He was angry. He was mad. He was furious with this Michael. Remember, Herod wanted to kill him whilst he was a boy. Revelation captures that. Remember, Revelation is the revelation of Jesus and about Jesus. Is coming from Jesus, and it is also of Jesus. So Jesus said, know who this enemy is. He tried to disrupt the entire universe, not only our planet Earth, even God. We destroyed him. We defeated him. He was not satisfied. Now he's come with a war against the child. Why? When this world entered into sin, Satan knew the only solution for our race was for Jesus to die. So immediately Jesus was born, he planned that he must be executed. He sent demons, so that they will play on the minds of Herod, for Herod to kill the child. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible was true when it says in 1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8, that be sober, be vigilant, because your adversary, the devil, he walks like a roaring lion. In fact, he says, seeking whom to devour. Just as he wants to devour a child, Satan has devoured many in this world. So when Jesus was born, Revelation 12 verse 5, she bore a male child. Remember we read Luke says her first son, who was to rule all nations with a rod of iron. This was a prophecy we saw yesterday in the book of Samuel and in the book of Genesis chapter 49 verse 9 and verse 10. Jesus was born and he was to be a son, and the Bible says, and her child was caught up to God and his throne. What is that supposed to mean? Revelation 19 verse 15, now out of his mouth goeth a sharp sword, that which is it should strike the nations, not just that, and he himself will rule them with a rod of iron. Talking about Jesus. And in Ephesians 1 verse 20, he says, he raised him from the dead and set him at his own right hand in the heavenly places. The child that was to be brought forth by the woman is none other, but it is Jesus Christ. Will you say an amen there? Amen. God caught him up. Acts chapter 1 verse 9 and verse 11, and he says, you men of Galilee, why gaze ye up into heaven? This same Jesus which you saw gone up, he shall come in the same manner. The child that was caught up in the sky is none other but Jesus. His name is Jesus. Will you say an amen there? He rose from the grave. Satan knew. He knew what Jesus would have done. Imagine, our world is in this state still, even after the death of Jesus. Imagine minus Jesus, how will this world be? Satan is an enemy. Why do you play around him? Why do you dally with him? He doesn't like you. He hates our joy. He hates our peace. He hates our safety. The book of Revelation is exposing the personality of Satan. He is an evil angel, unmasking the masked enemy. Ladies and gentlemen, the Bible says, Revelation chapter 12 verse 9, so the great dragon, Michael defeated him, he did not prevail. So the great dragon, look at the adjective that was used to describe, not just a dragon, the great dragon, he was cast out, that serpent of old, called the devil and called Satan, who deceives the whole world. In the next few slides, I will explain that he was cast to the air and his angels were cast out with him. The dragon was cast out. My point tonight is this. Satan is that angel that had and he stood against God's authority. Michael defeated him. He gave, and he want to attack Michael in his human form. When he was a child, he was again defeated. But you see, he was now cast down. But he was not going to give up. Look at him come in another form. And another sign appeared in heaven. And behold, a great, fiery, red dragon. There is an upgrade. This is the updated version of the dragon. First, it was a great dragon. In verse 3, another sign, a great, fiery, red dragon. Having 7 heads, I will give the characteristics. I will leave them for some other time. We are dealing with it. And he has 7 diadems on his head. His tail drew a third of the stars of heaven. When Satan was coming from heaven, after he was defeated by Michael, he brought a third of the angels. Listen to me. Who tells you Satan cannot deceive your pastor? Who tells you Satan cannot deceive your father? Who tells you Satan cannot deceive you? Who tells you Satan cannot deceive me? Ladies and gentlemen, we are not saying this criminal was able to convince 1/3 of the angels. Do you know the numbers of the angels? Thousands times 10,000 times thousands of thousands. They are numerous. In other words, Satan has 1/3 of innumerable angels. Let me put it differently. These angels that came with Satan, that fell with Satan, they are now demons. They are now mummy waters. They are now Ashtaroth. They are now Asmodeus. They are now Beelzebub. Name them. They are innumerable. We are not safe. On our own, we are not safe. On our own, he will crush us. On our own, he will destroy us. Listen, he was cast to the earth, and his angels were cast out with him. Using the change in phraseology, his angel. Is he a creator? Revelation is saying, anyone who believes the deception of Satan, you have sold yourself to him, including angels. His angels. In other words, when God comes for the restitution and the executive judgment, God loves us. But the reason why God would destroy the sinner is that God wants to destroy sin and any container that has sin in it will also be destroyed. The great dragon. Let's go through this. A dragon is a strange, changing being of destruction. A dragon. Satan is a strange, changing being with an intention to destroy. When the book of Revelation says the dragon, the great dragon, it means a great, strange, changing being of destruction. When he says a great, fiery, red dragon, it means a great, fiery, red, strange, changing, destruction element. His agenda is to destroy. When they called him the serpent, he's subtle. He's not easily detected. That is why today, because he's aware, many people are calling for religion. They are calling for Christianity. So he has made a way like a snake under a green grass. Subtly, Satan is deceiving many Christians, including pastors. He said to be the devil. The devil is an evil spirit. It's a mischievous, deliberate, and in an act to cause harm and damage and distress. Do you want him as a friend? An evil spirit, a mischievous spirit, a deliberate spirit that has an agenda to cause harm, to cause damage, and to cause distress. How can you be distressed again in a distressing Lagos? We are told, Revelation called him Satan. It means he's wicked. He's like a diabolos. The Greek word diabolos. He is diabolic. He's fiendish. He's exceptionally cruel. He's never forgiving. He never blesses. That is why those who go for blood money, he kills them. Today, many young people, because they have lost confidence in the clergy and in the church and in the Bible, they are going and they are shaking the hands of Satan to get money, to get land, to get business, to get car. Hey, he is wicked, he is diabolic, he is fiendish, he is cruel. That is why the Bible says he came to steal, to kill, and to destroy. He will steal away your joy. He will kill your ambition. He will make you useless. And finally, he will deceive you. He is a thief. He takes things without our permission. He entices us. He convinces us, unmasking the masked man. But the Bible didn't stop there. Revelation gave it a very twisting event. Revelation 12 verse 10. I love this one. It says, and I heard. Did he just say I heard? No. A loud voice. And it was saying, now is salvation and strength and the kingdom of our God. Listen to the phrases and look at the adjective and look at the verse. Now is our salvation. Look at the adverbs. Our salvation is come, and the strength and the kingdom of our God, and the power of his Christ. Why? The accuser of our brothers is cast down. Hey, even heaven rejoice over Satan leaving their premises. And young men, young women, today we encourage him to be in our homes, in our rooms, in our cars, because we listen to his music, we watch his film, and we act according to his dictates. Ladies and gentlemen, Satan is anti-good personality. He accuses us before God, not once a while, day end nigh. In other words, Revelation says, if there is any among us who always accuses the brethren, as for your jaw, you have a spiritual gift in finding fault. You have a problem. You don't see good in people. You know the spirit controlling you, Satan's spirit. Look at how the Bible put it. Therefore, rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. This is repetitive. In chapter 12, verse 11, they are saying, now salvation, now we are free, is no more here. Verse 12, they said, therefore, rejoice, O heavens, and you who dwell in them. Why? Woe to the inhabitants of the earth and the sea. Why? For the devil has come down to you. Anytime the devil has come down to you, woe. Anytime he's a friend, woe. Anytime he's a cousin, woe. Satan is an enemy. Bible says heaven felt sorry for our planet because Satan has come to us. Why? Revelation says Satan has a short time. He has a short time because he's going to work with wrath, because his days are numbered. No wonder when he gets into the Garden of Eden, not long after he was cast down, Genesis 1 verse 28, the dominion that God gave mankind, Satan usurped it. He came like a serpent. Genesis 3 verse 1, has God indeed said, you shall not eat of every tree of the garden? He didn't make a statement. He asked a question. Whenever Satan wants to engage you, he begins with a question. And look at it. Eve was listening. Women, be careful. Eve was anxious. She answered a serpent, we may eat. Remember, a serpent, he is so subtle. Satan, you can't easily detect him. This is serious. These characteristics, we will use them when it comes to interpreting scripture, when it comes to issues of worship, when it comes to issues of obedience, when it comes to issues of pleasing God. You can't really easily know on your own. It says, we may eat the fruit of the trees of the garden, but the fruit of the tree which is in the midst of the garden, God has said. What did God say? You shall not eat, nor shall you touch it, lest you die. The second to last day's sermon, I caption it, the untold truth, you shall surely die. He engaged and he counteracted what God intended. The same thing he did for one third of the angels. Satan will use the Bible. Today in Nigeria and across the world, those watching via various sectors, live streaming in your room, in auditorium, Satan, he knows the Bible. He says, for God knows, he is using us to stand against God. Remember, that the day you eat it, your eyes will be open and you will be like God. If you put it differently, he was saying, if you say, the day I will be like God. I will know all things. All he did this time was he repackaged it. If as sin came, but the Bible says in Romans 6:16-17, this was why they called the fallen angels his angels. He said, do you not know that to whom you present yourselves slaves to obey, you are that one slaves whom you obey? Jesus made it so clear through the Apostle Paul. So the question comes tonight, who do you obey, Michael, or you obey the dragon? The choice determines who is the ruler over your life. You ask people, who is your master? A Christian in fornication will say God. A Christian in idolatry will say God. A Christian into lie will say God. It is not just saying God. Who do you obey? For the past 20